Hey everybody, welcome back. It's Mr. Bruin. In today's lecture, we're going to talk about the five big ideas of the AP Computer Science Principles class. Let's list those five big ideas. Creative development, data, algorithms and programming, computer systems and networks, and number five, impact of computing. These five big ideas are part of the newly redesigned AP Computer Science class, redesigned in 2020. There used to be seven big ideas and they've narrowed it down to five. Let's talk about each one. Creative development. This is a big idea in this class, is that computing and computer science is a creative activity. It's highly creative. This creativity in computing spurs innovation, new ideas, inventions, that kind of thing. Computing fosters exploration that helps people solve big problems, whether they be societal and global problems or even personal problems. But computing is all about solving problems. So I'd like you to pause the video here for just a second and reflect. What is one computer innovation or invention that has changed the world in your lifetime? That would be something that maybe didn't exist at the time you were born, but was invented and has changed the world. Think about that for a second, and then come back to the video. Actually, answering this question is easy for me because I was born way, way back. I'm really old. And when I was born, there wasn't even such a thing as a personal computer. So personal computers were invented in the 1980s. And so I saw that change in our world. And personal computers have definitely changed the world we live in. Let's give you an example of how inventions and innovations foster creativity. Think about Google Maps for a second. This is a really cool innovation. But what's even more exciting is how Google Maps has been used to spur on other inventions and innovations and creative apps. For example, Plane Finder. It's a really ingenious plane tracking tool. And again, they use the Google Maps technology and data to map planes all around the world. Or how about this hiking app? Again, they take the Google Maps data and they help you map your hike, your run, that kind of thing. And it's a really creative and innovative idea. Streetviolence.org, this was launched by a charity in the United Kingdom, and it helps people map where there might be street violence or violent assaults going on in their city so that they can stop crime. Another great idea. The CNN uses their iReport map where just regular citizens can report news as they see it happening and submit pictures and things like that. And again, they're using the Google Maps idea but improving on it and doing something innovative and creative. How about this one, heat map? Another example of using Google Maps, this time to help combat climate change. You can even use Google Map information in games like Mindfold. It's a Minecraft type game. And they again allow you to take a Google Map and use it for your Minecraft world. Really creative and fun. How about Zombie Outbreak Simulator, okay? It's an iPhone app and allows you with a Google map of your area, show it being overrun by marauding zombies, okay? You get the idea. So the point I'm trying to make is that one really cool innovation, Google Maps, was created, and then that spurred on all kinds of other creative inventions and innovations and ideas that have changed our world. Big idea number two, data. Data facilitates the creation of knowledge. I don't know if you've ever thought about it that way, but as we collect more data about the world we live in, it actually helps us understand our world better. It creates new knowledge. All computer programs use and manipulate data, the information that we put in, and then it churns and manipulates that data and then spits out new information on the other end. And so computer programs use and manipulate data. That's why we call this the information age, okay? We used to live, for example, in the industrial age. And in that age, we use machines to change our world. In this age, we're using information or data to change the world we live in. Processing data, again, allows us to contribute knowledge, new knowledge to our world. Big idea number three, algorithms and programming. Algorithms, this big idea is kind of divided in two parts. Algorithms are used to develop and express solutions to computational problems. Here's a definition of the word algorithm. An algorithm is simply a step-by-step process for solving a problem. It's as simple as that. These algorithms, as they're called, can also be called functions or procedures or maybe even methods or subroutines in different languages. But again, they're just a simple step-by-step process to solve a problem. Again, I'd like you to pause the video and reflect. What is an algorithm, or in other words, a step-by-step process that you use every day? Stop and think about that. Now, I could answer this question with something as simple as brushing my teeth. It's something I do every day. It's a problem in the sense that I don't want my teeth to fall out and rot, and I got to solve that problem. So what do? I brush my teeth. So what do? I go into the bathroom. I get my toothbrush. I get my toothpaste. I put the toothpaste on the toothbrush. I get it wet. I stick it in my mouth, and I brush my teeth for at least 20 or 30 seconds on each side, and then I clean the brush, and I put it away. That is a step-by-step process to solve a problem. It could be called an algorithm. So an algorithm is kind of a fancy word, but it's really a pretty simple thing. And it's used all the time in programming. In this class, we will talk a lot about algorithms. Algorithms are used within programming. So programming enables this problem solving and human expression and creation of knowledge. And of course, it is a primary subject of study in this class. We will do a lot of programming. The language we're going to use in our class is JavaScript, but there are a lot of other languages you could use, and different AP Computer Science Principles classes use different languages. We're going to use JavaScript. So again, pause and define. This, you may have never thought of this before. You use computer programs all the time, but if you had to define what is a computer program to another person, what would you tell them? Think about that for a second. Well, here's my definition. A computer program is a collection of instructions. Well, instructions could be another word for algorithms, but a collection of algorithms or instructions that perform a specific task when executed by a digital analytical device. A digital analytical device is just another way of saying a computer. Big idea number four, computer systems and networks. This big idea used to be called the internet, but they decided to change the name and broaden it a little bit to just say computer networks. But the internet is the biggest network of all. And so we'll talk a lot in this class about the internet. The internet pervades modern computing. The internet, if you had to define it, is simply a big global network of networks. It's kind of the mother of all networks. And it's really made up of a lot of smaller networks. Almost every organization, institution has a computer network of some type. The school that you go to school in has a computer network. The business where your parents work has a computer network. People even have computer networks in their homes. Computer networks support communication, collaboration, and commerce. Networks are everywhere. They're a big part of our life. So why don't you pause again this video and list. What are three ways in which the internet has changed our world? Think about it. Three ways in which the internet has changed our world. Well, I'm not going to list three, but I'm going to give you one. The internet created the need for cybersecurity. Think about it. Before the internet, you never had to worry about someone stealing your identity online because there was no online. But now that's a really big concern. It's a huge concern in our world today. There's a whole industry now that's built up around cybersecurity. And so that is one way that our world has changed because of the internet. There are lots of ways. So again, try to list some. And big idea number five, the last one, impact. Computing has had a huge impact on our world. In fact, it's had a global impact. It's really changed our world in many different ways and every part of our world. Computing has changed the way people think, the way they work, the way they live, the way they play, the way they talk even, the things they talk about, the things they do with their time, how they are productive, how they make money, all of that stuff. All of that stuff has been changed because of computing. And so studying computer science, studying the way computers work, studying coding and programming are a very important part of the world we live in. And so I'm glad you're taking this class, because you're going to see the kind of impact that computing has had in our world. But one thing to think about is that these impacts have possibly both benefits, good results, and also possible harmful effects, right? Most things that have big impacts do. They can be used for good and they can be used for bad. And so another thing you might want to think about is, what are the possible harmful effects that computing, computer science, the internet, things like that have had on our world? Because there are possible harmful effects as well. And in this class, you'll be thinking and asked to think about both the positive and possible negative effects of computing. So there you have it, the five big ideas: creative development, data, algorithms and programming, computer systems and networks, and the impact of computing. Everything we study in this class will fall within one of these five big ideas. So as we learn new things, you might want to ask yourself, well, which big idea is this a part of? How does this fit into the overall class? Because this is the framework for AP Computer Science Principles. Thanks for watching. See you next time.